Hi, Mark Donovan here from Falcon Imagery. Today I'm going to go over pressure altitude. Pressure altitude is an important concept to understand because all of the performance characteristics in terms of takeoff and landing and cruise performance are based on pressure altitude in the pilot operating handbooks for aircraft. Hi, Mark Donovan here from Falcon Imagery. Today I'm going to go over pressure altitude. Pressure altitude is an important concept to understand because all of the performance characteristics in terms of takeoff and landing and cruise performance are based on pressure altitude in the pilot operating handbooks for aircraft. What we put into the Kollsman window for a barometric pressure gives us the true elevation of the aircraft over the earth, but it doesn't give us the pressure altitude. And the pressure altitude is the information we need because that's going to tell us how the aircraft is going to actually perform relative to how many feet we are above the ground and true altitude. So what is pressure altitude? The simplest definition is pressure altitude is the true altitude corrected for non-standard pressure. Now what is non-standard pressure? Well, first of all, standard atmospheric pressure or standard atmosphere is when the temperature is 15 degrees Celsius or 59 degrees Fahrenheit and the pressure on the barometer reads 29.92 inches of mercury. Again, this is at sea level. If we come over to this column of air here, you'll notice that there's particles of air molecules that are very densely populated near the surface of the Earth. But as we go up in elevation, the air molecules get further and further apart, and that is due to gravity's pull on the air molecules. Another important concept to understand is that for every 1,000 feet in elevation, you lose about 1 inch of mercury. So in this chart here, I go from 1,000 feet up to 7,000 feet. And over here, I plot the inches of mercury in the barometer. So at sea level, we have 29.92 inches of mercury on a standard 15 degrees Celsius day. We're at sea level. We go up 1,000 feet, we drop 1 inch of mercury. So we see 28.92 inches of mercury. And we can continue going up in elevation to 7,000 feet. And at 7,000 feet, we'd see 22.92 inches of mercury. So with this information in mind, we can now go out and get the barometric reading at an airport, for example, and determine what the pressure altitude is or calculate what the pressure altitude is. And that's what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a couple examples on how to calculate the pressure altitude based off the barometric pressure reading that you get when you listen to the ASOS or AWOS at your local airport. So I'm going to look at two examples here. One of them I've already done out. I'm going to show you how we do the math and what we get for performance. So I'm doing, again, two examples. The first I'm going to do is departing out of Laconia Airport, KLCI, and we listen to the AWOS, and we hear it says 28.42 inches of mercury. We would dial that into the Kollsman window on the barometer, and we should read the field elevation, which is 545 feet. Now that's good in terms of, you know, showing that the altimeter is working correctly, but we need to know what the pressure altitude is to see how the aircraft's going to perform at takeoff. So the other thing is, we plan to cruise out of Laconia Airport at 5,500 feet. That's our cruise altitude. So the first thing we want to do is we want to take the standard pressure altitude, the standard pressure for a standard atmosphere, 29.92 inches, and we're going to subtract from it the 28.42 inches. And we come out with 0.500. Now, if we remember right over here, every 1,000 feet we go up, we lose an inch of mercury. So here we're showing that we lose about a half an inch of mercury. That's what the math works out to. So we have to multiply this 0.5 by 1,000, and we come out with 500 feet. Now the question is, what do we do with that 500 feet? Well, we're going to either have to add or subtract, depending what the pressure reading is, the AWOS, relative to the standard pressure. In this particular situation, example one, we get an AWOS number that says 28.42 inches of mercury is what they're reading. What that tells us, the air pressure is lower pressure than the standard pressure. And as a result of that, we're going to take our field elevation, 545 feet, and have to add 500 feet, the number we just calculated, to come up with our pressure altitude. And we come up with 1,045 feet. That is the takeoff pressure altitude that we would use in our calculation, to look in the charts to determine the performance takeoff of the aircraft. because the pressure is actually lower than the standard pressure here from what the AWOS reported. The second part of this is that the cruise elevation, we said 5,500 feet. Well, the similar type of thing. We have to take that 5,500 feet and add 500 to it, and we come up with 6,000 feet. So our pressure altitude for our cruise performance would be the 6,000 feet, not the 5,500. We're actually flying at 5,500 feet because that's we've got the right barometric pressure put in, the 28.42, and that's now giving us the true altitude above sea level. But how the aircraft will perform is as if it thinks it's at 6,000 feet. And it's that number we use in the cruise performance tables to determine the actual performance of the aircraft. Now we're going to do example two. In example two, we get an AWOS report from Laconia Airport saying 30.42 inches of mercury. So in this example, we take the 30.42 and subtract from it the standard pressure of 29.92. And we come up with 0.5. Remember, we have to multiply times 1,000 because you lose 1 inch of mercury for every 1,000 feet. We determine the number 500 feet. So in this case, we need to determine whether or not we add or subtract from the field elevation of 542 feet. Now remember now, we got 30.42 inches of mercury. That's a higher pressure than the standard pressure. So the air molecule is going to even be denser. So if we come over to our column again and we see at sea level, it's 29.92 inches of mercury. At 30.42 inches, we're like somehow down underneath the surface of the Earth. So that's what we got to do here. We're going to basically take the 500 feet, since the pressure that we got reported is higher than the standard pressure, we're going to subtract 500 feet, which leaves us with 45 feet. So we're going to look in the takeoff performance charts for the aircraft, not at the 545 feet elevation, but at actually 45 feet elevation. It's the same situation here with the cruise level. Again, we were going to cruise at 5,500 feet. Well, based on this higher pressure than the standard pressure, we're now going to subtract the 500 feet here as well, and we get 5,000 feet. So our pressure altitude cruise number is 5,000 feet. The aircraft, again, will be flying truly at 5,500 feet above the surface of the Earth because we put in the 30.42 inches of mercury in the Kollsman window on our altimeter, but the how the aircraft will perform will be as if it's flying at 5,000 feet. You're going to see, since we're actually going to perform at 5,000 feet, we're going to get a little bit better performance even though we're flying at the true altitude of 5,500 feet. So the last thing I want to cover is a true life example where we're putting in some actual barometric pressure readings into the Kollsman window on our altimeter along our route of flight. In this example, I'm showing us flying from Laconia Airport in New Hampshire to Auburn Lewiston in Maine. We listen to the AWOS of both airports, we get that information. Laconia is reporting 30.42 inches of mercury, and Auburn Lewiston is reporting 28.92 inches of mercury. It's important to understand that those barometric readings are what the barometric pressure is at sea level, not what it is at that particular airport. If we look at these two charts here, we have sea level 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, etc., same over here. But what we do differently is we're putting in our reference point of 30.42 inches of mercury representing sea level. We drop an inch, 29.942 inches of mercury here, we have 1,000 feet, 28.42, 2,000 feet, etc. Over here is a little different because we started at 28.92 representing sea level. So it's 27.92, 26.92 for 2,000, etc. So we take off out of Laconia, and we're going to fly at approximately a 29.875-inch pressure level, which translates into about 545 feet above the surface of the Earth, which is the field elevation of that airport. We're going to fly up to 5,500 feet MSL, or the true altitude above the Earth. And when we do, looking at the charts, we're going to see we're roughly at about a 24.875-inch pressure level, representing at 5,500 feet as we leave Laconia at cruise altitude. As we near the Auburn-Lewiston Airport, we must put in the 28.92 inches in the Kollsman window on that altimeter. Otherwise, what will happen is we'll continue to fly that pressure level, but that pressure level represents a different true altitude above the Earth because the pressure at sea level up around Auburn Lewiston was 28.92 inches, not the 30.42 over here. So if we continue to fly without correcting for the barometric pressure at KLU, we're going to find that our true altitude is going to go from 5,500 feet to about 4,200 feet by the time we get to Auburn Lewiston airport area. And that could be a dangerous situation. You may have heard an expression, high to low, watch out below, or hot to cold, watch out to below. Well, this is the pressure side. Going from a high pressure to a low pressure, you run the risk, if you don't put in new barometric readings along the way or at your destination, you're going to find yourself flying at different true altitudes above the Earth. You want to make sure you're flying, in this case, 5,500 feet along the whole cruise route. So we've got to make sure we put the new AWOS number in here for KLU Airport to ensure that we do fly at that true altitude of 5,500 feet. Anyways, that's what pressure altitude is about, why we use it. Hopefully you found this video helpful. If you did, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and make sure you hit the notification bell so you get notified when I come out with my next video.